Hello everyone. Now we are studying about the interface keyword. Now what is the interface keyword? What are the uses? What are the how it is extended and how the interface is implemented? So these points are discussed in this PPT. Okay, now the introduction of the interface. So what is the interface keyword and how it is used? So using the keyword interface, we can fully abstract a class and the interface forms its implementations. The interfaces are syntactically similar to the classes, but they lack the instance variables and their methods are declared without any body. So using the interface, the work of the class can be specified, but you cannot define how it does it. So in other words, you can say that the interfaces can have the abstract methods and the variables, but it cannot have a method body. With the keyword interface, Java allows to fully utilize the one interface and the multiple methods aspect of polymorphism. And once the interface is defined, any number of the classes can implement an interface. So one class can implement any number of the interfaces. So to implement an interface, a class must create the complete set of the methods defined by the interface. So as you all already studied that in the inheritance, Java does not support the multiple inheritance. So at this situation, interface is used because by using the interface, the multiple inheritance is achieved in Java. So basically, the interfaces are designed to support the dynamic resolution at runtime. And interfaces separate the definition of a method or set of the methods from the inheritance hierarchy. So basically, the interfaces are designed to support the dynamic method resolution. Okay. So in order for a method to be called from one class to another, both the classes need to be present at compile time, so that the Java compiler can check to ensure that the method signatures are compatible or not. So this requirement by itself makes for a static and non-extensible classing environment. So this unavoidable situation in a system, a functionality is provided at higher order in the class hierarchy. Therefore, the method may be available to the subclasses. So this situation is very inevitable or unavoidable. So at that situation, interfaces are used. So we can say that interfaces are designed to solve this problem, because interface separate the definition of a method or set of methods from the inheritance hierarchy. Now the next is how we can define the interface or defining an interface. An interface is defined much like a class. So the interface also contains the methods and the variables, but with major difference, the interface defines only abstract methods and the final fields. So this means that interface do not specify any code to implement those methods and the data fields. It contains only constants. And hence, this is the class responsibility to implement an interface and defines the implementations of these methods. So there is a syntax for defining an interface. Syntax is access interface name, then return type method name 1, that is parameter list, return type method 2, parameter list, then variables, we can define the type final variable 1 is equal to value, type final variable 2 is equal to value. So return type method name n parameter list and type final variable n is equal to value. So in the syntax where access, okay, so here access is either public or not used. Okay, it's public or not used. When no access modifier is included, then the default access modifier is used and the interface is only available to the other methods of the package in which it is declared. And when it is declared as public, then interface can be used by any other code. Okay, so next in the syntax is access the interface. Interface is used as an interface keyword. Then name. Okay, interface, it is a keyword. The name. Name is the name of the interface and it is any valid Java identifier. Then variables, see here. Variables that type final variable 1, 2. So what are these variables? Variables are implicitly final and the static. Okay, meaning that the implementing class cannot change them. Okay, so they must be initialized with a constant value. All the variables are implicitly public if the interface itself is declared as public. Then the method declaration, return type method name 1, 2. Okay, so what is the method declaration? Methods are declared with no bodies and are essentially abstract. Okay, the method declaration contains only a list of the methods without any body statement and ends with semicolon. So each class that includes an interface must implement all these methods. Okay, this is the syntax for defining the interface. Now see here one of the example of the interface. So how we can define the interface? Interface keyword is user and callback. Callback, it is the name of the interface. Callback. Then there is one method is declared here, that is void callback, and there is integer p there is. So this method is end with the semicolon. Okay, we are not defining here. We are just declaring that method and end with the semicolon. The method name is also callback. Now how we can implement that interface? Implementing interface. To implement an interface includes the implements clause in the class definition. So once an interface has been defined, one or more classes can implement that interface. Interfaces are used as superclass whose properties are inherited by the classes. So create class that inherit interface. To implement an interface, include the implements clause in the class definition and then create the methods defined by that interface. So what is the syntax of the implementing interface? The syntax is access, class, class name, then extends superclass, then implements interface and comma interface. So here, see here, access is either public or not used. Okay. Class, it is the class keyword, and class name. Class name, it is the name of that class and whose implements the interface name. If a class implements more than one interface, then that interfaces must be separated with the commas. So here this class implements more than one interface, so we can separate it by the comma here. So class can extend another class while implementing interfaces. So the same method name can be declared by the two interfaces of the same class. Then users of the either interface will use the same method. The method which implements the interface must be declared as public. Okay, see here, whatever the methods we are implementing the interface must be declared as a public access modifier. The type signature of the implementing method and the specified in interface definition must match. So this is the implementing interfacing syntax. So see here one example that implements the interface. So see here, there is one class, name of the class is client, which implements the interface, that is callback. And there is one method is defined here, public void callback integer p, and system.out.println the callback call with p. So see here, there is one point to be noted that the method which are declared in the interface, who that access modifier of that method is the public. So here I'm using this access modifier as the public void callback. Okay, and the class, the client who's implements that interface must define that method callback. Then the example that implements the class that implements interface can define the additional members of their own. Okay, so class client implement the method which are declared in the interface. So it is the permissible for the class that he can that class can also add its own methods also, which are not declared in the interface. So this class client also defines one method callback, which is declared in the interface callback. That is method is the callback, and also that interface also defines one method non-interface, which is not defined in the interface. This method is defined on its own, that class client. So see here, there is one method public void callback integer p. There is a simple println statement, and there is a void non-interface method is also of that class. Okay. So the next point is accessing implementations through interface references. So accessing implementations through interface references. So by using, we can access the implementation by using the reference created of that interface. So see here, variables can be declared as object references that use an interface rather than a class. So any instance of any class that implements the declared interface can be referred to by a such variable. Okay, when a method is called through one of these references, then the correct version will be called based on the actual instance of the interface being referred to. So this is the one of the important feature of the interface, because the method to be executed is looked up dynamically at runtime. So it allows the classes to be created later than the code which calls the methods on them. So the calling code can dispatch through an interface without having to know anything about the calling. So it is very important feature of that interface. So there is one example here, implementing interfaces through the interface reference. So there is one interface that is callback. There's one method is defined here, void callback. And there is a class client implements that callback, which I have taken here the previous example for the understanding. Then public void callback. There is a one method which are declared in the interface. We have to define here in the class client. Then there are another implementation of the callback. So there is another class, that is the name of that class is the another client. That class also implements the interface, that is callback. So this class also mandatory for the another class client to define the method which is declared in the interface callback. So this class defining the method that is callback, integer p. So there is a two println statement, another version of the callback, and the square of the p here. So which version of the callback method to be called is based on the type of the object pointing to by the interface reference. Understood? So there is also callback method in the another client class also, and there is another there is a callback method in the class client also. So this problem is solved by using the interface reference variable. So here there is a class test phase 2. There is in the main method. In the main method, C is the interface reference variable and pointing to the class object. See here, the statement is callback C is equal to the new client. So this interface reference variable is pointing to the client object. So there is another class, another client class, and I have created one object OB of that another client class. And now first we are trying to call that object c.callback42. Okay, c is the interface reference variable that calling the callback 42. So when this statement is executed, then callback method of the client class is executed. Okay, so output will be callback called with the 42. Next c now refers to the another client object. Now c is equal to the ob, and I am calling here c dot callback 42. So when the statement is executed, then callback of another client is called, and these two statements are executed. Okay, another version of the callback and square of the p. Now see here, output is callback called with 42, another version of the callback, and square of the p is 1764. So we can say from this example, we can say that we can use the interface reference variable pointing to the another class, and we can access the methods. So we can achieve the one type of the polymorphism here by using the interface reference variable. Okay. Next, what are the partial implementations? If a class includes an interface but does not fully implement the methods defined by that interface, then that class must be declared as abstract. Okay. And suppose class that does not fully implement that interface, then suppose that class is abstract, then any class that inherits such abstract class must implement methods defined in the interface. Or suppose that inheriting class also not implementing the methods defined in the interface, then that class must be declared as abstract itself. Next, what are the different variables in the interfaces? Variables declared in interface are considered as constant. So interfaces can be used to declare a set of the constants. When that interface is included in a class, then all of these variables in scope as constants. Then if an interface contains no methods, then any class that includes such an interface doesn't actually implement anything. So it is that class were importing the constant variables into the class name space and as final variables. The next point is extending the interface. One interface can inherit the another by use of the keyword extends. So interfaces can be extended like the class. An interface can be sub-interfaced from other interfaces. The newly sub-interface can inherit all of the members of the super interface like the subclasses. When a class implements an interface, that inherits another interface, and it must provide the implementations for all methods defined within the interface inheritance chain. Now, what are the different characteristics of an interface? So all the variables used in an interface are considered as the constants, although they are used without the keywords final and the static. Several interfaces can be combined together into a single interface. Interfaces are allowed to extend to other interfaces, but sub-interfaces cannot define the methods declared in the super interfaces. Super interfaces are still interfaces, not the classes. Instead, it is the responsibility of some other class that implements the derived interface to define all the methods. When an interface extends two or more interfaces, then these interfaces are separated by the commas. An interface cannot extend the classes as per the rule, but interface can have only abstract methods and the constants. So see here one of the example of the extending interfaces. So one interface can extend the another. There is one interface defined A, and there are the two methods show1 and show2 are declared here. Now B, it is the another interface which are extending the interface A. So B now also includes the show1 and the show2 methods which are declared in the interface A. And it can also add the show3 method in the interface B. So this B interface also contains the three methods, that is show1, show2 and show3. So this class, whichever the class we are defining, that class must implement all of the methods declared in the interface A and B. So there is a class, my class, which implements B. Then public void show1, that system.out.println is implementing show1, and public void show2, that is implementing show2, and show3 implementing show3. So here class if extend there, and in the main method my class object is there, a new class, and by using this object we can we are calling the show1 method, show2 and show3 method. Okay, then thank you.